Hi Libra, how's it going? I hope you're doing great. This is for Libra, Sun on rising sign, Venus placement, seventh house placement, or wherever you have Libra in your chart. This may or may not resonate with you. Please take what resonates, leave the rest. And I've already put out some cards. This is a choice. Someone can't take a choice towards this happiness. They have lost their confidence, lost money perhaps, and the road is blocked. That's what I'm hearing with this chariot in reverse. There is a lot of regret and trying to have this balance in their life. And the death and the emperor. Someone know that they had to change to get this happiness. And the Wheel of Fortune and the Ace of Cups. Judgment. Final decision with the judgment. And what's the Wheel of Fortune? Heartbroken. Three of Swords. And the Ace of Cups, please. Yeah, Ten of Cups in reverse. Someone regret. They juggled you or something. Yeah, and someone is in deep sorrow because of this. Because of. They fucked this up or something. The first draw, please. Yeah, this person has to change into an emperor to get close to you. Yeah, this is the Empress, the Temperance. And the Lovers again. Balance, harmony, healing, patience, self-control, moderation, purpose, peace, calm, tranquility. Yeah, it's like someone know that all of these qualities, you embody all these qualities. And the Lovers, divine love, deep soul connection. Yeah, someone wants to marry the Empress, the High Priestess. Seven of Swords over the High Priestess. What is this? Betrayal, deception, getting away with something, theft, dishonesty, sneakiness, cunning, shimming, strategy. Someone think that you are laying up a strategy or something like that. Someone maybe think you are lying about something. Or someone lied about you. What's the Seven of Swords? Ace of Cups. Knight of Pentacles. Yeah, someone think that they are never going to be able to forget you. They're always gonna have love for you. Testing of faith, the final push, boundaries, last stand, grit, close to success, fatigue. Yeah, because you have put up these clear and strong boundaries or something, so they can't come near you. Oh, Queen of Cups in reverse, Four of Cups and the Fool. Yeah, something about this Queen of Cups in reverse. Yeah, someone lived nearby this person. And was very careless. Was when they met you at some point in time, and they were was very unprepared for this meeting, and that this emperor would develop feelings for you, and this neighbor, or what it was, an ex, a neighbor, or someone that they was drinking with or something, they stopped paying attention to this person when they met you. And this Queen of Cups took a poor judgment. Was very naive, very careless about the ruin this connection. I was very careless about it. They didn't care. And this has happened in the past. Yeah, so this Queen of Cups in reverse. They started with some magic on this person who was in love with you. And to have this will to go in her favor. And yeah, creating illusions for this King of Cups. To create deception. Because of this person's jealousy. Yeah. Yeah, they were going towards this person. With try to show that they cared. And pretend to be in love with this person, just to tear them down, just to create some conflict, disagreements, competitiveness, and unfair defeat. They wanted to win at all costs. Was very aggressive as well, because they was intimidated by you, intimidated that this person would go towards you. And now they're in this Nine of Swords. Anxiety, depression, sleepless nights, overthinking, fear, nightmares, paranoia, negativity, and despair. And yeah, someone is finally saying no. Yeah. Try to lighten the load of something. Finally saying no to this person or something like that. I suppose this is a drinking buddy or something. It looks like this emperor won't exchange. They're afraid now. They have ruined everything. Because of the two of wands in reverse, they can't plan for this happiness, this great happiness. Unless they change, or they're afraid to die or something. I don't know. Let's see. What's the middle row, please? Three of Swords, heartbroken. Or this can be something about this person's heart. And no healing, the Star in reverse. And the Seven of Pentacles also in reverse. Yeah, feeling stuck in their head with the Eight of Swords. Yeah, heartache. Emotional pain, sorrow, trauma, grief, hurt, loss, depression, feeling broken, lack of faith, loss of hope, despair, disconnection, depression, and desperate negativity. Yeah, can't. They are in this negative spiral in their head because you have taken your energy back, Lack of long-term visions, lack of reward, impatient, giving up, too soon, lazy, setbacks, low effort, yeah, lack of growth, and self-imposed prison of sorts, limiting and negative thoughts, victim mentality. Yeah, they're a little bit in their victim mentality. Playing the victim. Why do this happen to me? And they don't take accountability for what they have done. Because you weren't the one who was breaking up this connection. You were truthful to this person. You were kind, loving. And this person had some wounds from their past, which they have refused to heal. So they play the victim instead. Yeah. They play the victim. And the judgment on this, I don't know if this person called judgment on this, that I have to change. Or nothing is going to change if I don't change. I don't know. But the judgment is up two times. Yeah, and the Four of Swords. This is sickness, can be. Or a retreat, a rest, relaxation, meditation. Solitude to gather your thoughts. Yeah. King of Swords, Ten of Cups, Five of Pentacles again, and the Page of Swords in reverse, and the Nine of Cups in reverse. Yeah, this person has to tame their inner wild animal. Yeah. Mental clarity. This can be that this person looking at this to get this Ten of Cups, they have to think in another way, in another direction, have the discipline to do so. Head over heart, take a head over heart decision, happiness towards divine love. And the Five of Pentacles, financial loss, poverty, lack, mindset, isolation. Yeah, this one is isolated themselves. Take no action, gossip, insulting, scatterbrain, cynical, sarcastic, lack of planning. Yeah. This is what they're thinking about, all the sarcastic things they said about you, the cynical ways, that they didn't take action, that they participate in gossip, insulting you. And this have made them very unhappy, lack of fulfillment, greed, laziness, negative indulgence. Yeah, this is someone who is drinking with this Queen of Cups in reverse, you know. Who wanted to stir up this connection with you because they saw that this person did like you a lot, you know. And yeah, someone was very arrogant. Yeah, and then they, in a sense, they regret all the things that they have said about you. Or this is something they do right now, I don't know. Very ungrateful. Underachieving, yeah. Because they don't have this confidence to come towards you. And take a choice. They don't take a choice. They have multiple priorities. And the Queen of Pentacles, another queen, a karmic, selfish, materialistic, gold digger, self-absorbed, envious, home work or home conflict, jealous, insecure, greedy, and intolerant. Yeah, so this person indulged in gossip about you with these two queens in reverse. Karmic, insecure bitches, you know. try to find some shit about you. Yeah, this person, or this person's, this drinking buddy, so what it was, it like, it's like they didn't want this person to be an emperor or a mature, take responsibility for their actions. Didn't want this person to grow up, be mature. And someone also created some obstacles for this emperor at the workplace. To have this person stuck in the past. Yeah. In some illusion. Yeah, clinging to the past. Oh my god, the Queen of Swords in reverse. This is three women. Manipulative, harsh, bitchy, cold, spiteful, cruel, deceitful, unforgiving, pessimistic, malicious, and bitter. Yeah, so this is the... This person is surrounding themselves with this kind of persons, you know? This kind of people. Yeah, the Ten of Pentacles and the Six of Swords and the Tower, Fear of Change, yeah. Avoiding a disaster. The moment has already passed. This is too late, you know? Oppression, carelessness, neglect, and apathy, yeah. They're giving up. They have given up. Yeah, it's like they have seen something about this Ten of Pentacles. They have to move away to get to this Ten of Pentacles because there are in this Five of Pentacles. There's a lack of money, there's a lack of mentality. Yeah. They have to be in a positive, pure energy to get to manifest better. Yeah, they're thinking about moving to have a new job. But they are fighting with themselves, try to find their own strength, and yeah, someone don't think that this is possible. You can't change your life. Try to bully this person, try to play the victim with this person, try to have him unfocused, try to have him or her ruthless, arrogant, restless, impulsive. Yeah, in this Knight of Wands, this player energy. Or this is something that has come to light, what they made money off, or made their money from, or something. Something, yeah, someone maybe illuminated something with this player base and justice. Yeah, this is justice, fairness, universal laws, yeah. This is karma, cause and effect. Truth is revealed. And consequences for their action, yeah. Three of Wands. Two of Wands and the Nine of Pentacles. And the Ten of Swords. Recovery, yeah. Try to recover from something that was hidden in the dark, under the moon. So they isolated themselves. And try to be more mature, perhaps. Try to be more, I don't know. If the Two of Swords, yeah, difficult decision, weighing of options, doubt, inner conflict, and they avoid the change. Yeah, try to defend themselves, regret something. And the Hangman in reverse, this is delays, resistance, yeah, this person can't take the final decision about this change, having this better life. It's obviously not a good life where they're at, but they have to take the first step, you know, and when they take the first step, this, their money will improve, you know, they will have more love in their life. They have to also give more self-love to themselves, forgive themselves for past actions and behavior, feeling unwelcome, they want to call you or something. Or the one, or they have talked to someone who don't like you and have told lies about you to stir up some conflict, some disagreement, tension. Very aggressive. Clash of egos, yeah. And the Page of Pentacles, lack of progress, immature. Yeah, this person has to say to themselves, I am the captain of my ship. No one else is the captain of my ship. They can't let this devil take over their life. Yeah, this is sex addiction or something like that. Or they have done too many stupid things under the influence and, yeah. Not being distracted by other things. Yeah, what did I say? They have to take accountability, trust in themselves. Illusions ends, yeah. Maybe they finally see the truth about this. Either this person was like this, sex addicted, they have sex with everyone, or this person, this queens underneath here, that they were them that was like this, or they participated in this, you know. I don't say that this person have no guilt, you know, because they have, because they never trusted fully in themselves. Yeah. Lack of movement into this Two of Cups, this real love, you know. Yeah. They want to give you something. Generosity, they want to be generous towards you. But they have some financial insecurity. They are reckless. King of Wands, Eight of Pentacles, they're probably working with some male energies as well. Knight of Cups, moody, turmoil, avoiding conflict, vanity. Yeah, there was very much vanity in this environment. Maybe they were working together with this king and King of Pentacles, King of Wands. There was some sort of jealousy between them or disappointment. The Eight of Cups. Fully learning from the past. Returning home. Aimlessness. Staying in a bad situation. Avoidance. Fear of change. Okay. Yeah. No, this person is going around and around and around in the same cycle over and over again. New material offer. I don't know. New job. Yeah, can be a new job. And ending something. World travel can be. Yeah, Six of Wands and the Ace of Swords. Two positive cards at the end. And I think if this person taking responsibility, take the full responsibility for their own life, this is going to happen. They are going to have this victory, you know, and see the truth for what it is. And yeah. And don't play the victim role. Don't drink their problems away. Don't indulge with this karmic companions, you know, drinking buddies. Yeah, because there is no healing as long as they don't want to change. You know, they can't sit and wait for someone to come and rescue them, come and drag them up from their couch and come and rescue them. That's not how it works. You have to take the first step yourself, and the universe will help you on the way. You know, the universe helps those who help themselves. That's how it is. Okay. One shaman oracle card today for Libras. The circle, yeah, the circle. They have to the moon, yeah, the moon faces. They have to begin a new circle or nothing will change for this person. This is 8. This is everything you have saw comes back. And karma is also connected to the 8. Pluto is also connected to the 8. The scorpion is also connected to the 8. So this is a circle we have been in for too long. And the universe says, do something about it. And this 7, 37 is a 10, you know. And this, the universe said, end this. And your life will improve little by little. You know, be patient. Yeah. Okay, Libra. I hope it helps. And I wish you all the best. Bye-bye.